Before we start this video, we want to give a big shout out to all of you guys. Thank you so much for 100,000 subscribers on YouTube. I know this video is not really that special, but something very special is going to be coming very soon to celebrate 100,000 subscribers. So thank you for watching and I hope you enjoy the video.
The Maruti Suzuki Swift, the OG Indian hatchback. There has never been a generation of Swift that hasn't captured the Indian market for being a fun, frugal pocket rocket. But with the trend of hatchbacks going up in size and down in fun, I had a question. Does the new Swift still have what it takes to capture our hearts? Let's find out. Without dilly-dallying, let's see what's under the heart of this tiny little beast. If I can open the engine.
Bruh.
Yes. So, we all loved the K12 and the G13B that were part of the previous generations of Swift. You now get a brand new engine, which is a cylinder-less compared to the older two. This is a Z12E engine. It's a 1.2-litre 3-cylinder, 12-valve engine that produces 82 bhp and 108 newton meters of torque. The priority, as per Suzuki's claims, is low-end grunt. And this is the first ever Suzuki Swift engine that comes with low-end grunt and does not prioritize that peaky top end. What does that mean for you and me? Let's find out. While the Swift that is available abroad gets a CVT gearbox with paddle shifters, the Indian Swift gets two transmission options. One is a 5-speed manual gearbox and two is an AMT gearbox, exactly what I'm driving today. The new generation Swift is part of the previous Hartect platform. It's still developed with the platform that was there in the previous generation Swift, but now it is 25 kgs heavier. That is because you now have airbags, which are side and curtain airbags, to add a little bit of extra safety. And we all know what is the safety rating of the previous Swift. So I'm not going to get into that. The engineers have also made some technical changes to the dynamics of how this car drives. The rear suspension is now stiffer and there is an improved stabilizer bar in the front, adding to that involvement in the drive. Talking about this AMT gearbox, out of all the gearboxes that I've been AMT and I've driven, this is pretty impressive. It is smooth, it is predictable, and it also doesn't do a sloppy change. Like, it does change smoothly and it does change competently. So you don't feel like it is just a jerky gearbox, but yeah, it is still slow. You still feel like the lack of involvement is there. You would prefer a manual gearbox. And considering how fun this engine can be, I definitely can understand why would people just opt for the manual instead if you are a proper driver. Talking about how this AMT performs by itself, well, while pondering around town, it is very nice. It doesn't really jerk about, and the shifts, while noticeable, are subtle enough for you to overlook them. And that is a good thing for the average city goer. But for someone like you and me, when we push the engine through its revs, you are going to feel a little bit of notchiness anywhere above 3-4,000 RPM. And even switching it to manual mode doesn't really help with the responsiveness of the gearbox. However, in terms of AMTs, it still does a commendable issue, and compared to other Maruti AMTs, it is a very big improvement. Talking about the Z12E, I am pretty happy with how refined the engine is. even at the higher rev range, where it is 4,000-5,000 RPM, you feel a subtle buzz, but it is much better than what you would expect from, I don't know, a Polo 1-liter TSI, which has a more lively engine. This has been designed to be more grunty in the bottom, and that's where most of its power is available, and it tapers off pretty smoothly at the top. So 4,000-5,000 RPM, you will start feeling the power going down. And when it comes to pushing the car, I'm pleased to report that it definitely drives much, much nicer than the previous generations, thanks to the reworked suspension and the stabilizer bar in the front. It dives in very well. The roll has been checked very well compared to the previous Swift. And yeah, if this car was to be having more power, or if you want to actually push the car, you're definitely going to enjoy what this car offers dynamically. One thing that will really put a smile on an enthusiast's face is how the suspension has been set up on the Swift. Yes, it is noticeably stiffer compared to the previous generation, but that has really fixed body roll. And now, chucking it into a corner, it's very confidence-inspiring. And even with these slim tires, it definitely has quite a lot of more mechanical grip, which allows the driver to have much more confidence while pushing the car. Yes, the stiffness will be a little bit cumbersome on a rough patch. However, it is not bone-breaking bad. It's not bone-breaking stiff. You're going to be perfectly fine driving over rough roads as long as you are careful about it and you don't go absolutely nuts. So while the suspension stiffness might drive away some people that might think that it could be a bit too harsh on the road, the enthusiast will actually love this setup because it's so taut in the corners. So all in all, the Swift has retained its youthfulness in the driving department. But how does it do in the appeal department? Let's park up somewhere and start with the interior. The new Swift also comes with an all-new interior and a new dash layout with this massive screen protruding right on the top, which is very nice and visible. You get a larger screen in the better variant. This is the base spec variant, so you pretty much get no trim at all. So in the base variant, you get a completely black interior except for the silver lining bits on the steering wheel, which actually looks really nice, and the steering wheel itself is very nice to hold. Apart from that, I really feel like they could have added some pizzazz into the interior with some color matching bits of trim or something, because it is very monotonous in here right now. But overall, the steering wheel feels nice to hold. The driving position ergonomically is very involving, and even the seats are they are bolstered very well, so you are pretty confident while driving the car. In terms of fit and finish, it has gone up in terms of quality and fit from the previous generations, but I really still feel like they could have omitted all of these scratchy hard plastics everywhere and made something a little softer or nicer to the touch here and there. Overall, a pretty useful interior. And last but not the least, the looks. Let's start from the rear end. The Swift has actually retained a lot of what has made it recognizable. Pompous from the bottom and skinny from the top. It has always made it look very nice, and in my opinion, the rear end is where it looks the nicest. I really like the new tail lights, the new bumper, and especially this character line on the boot that makes it a bit more sporty from the back. Moving on towards the side profile, you can notice that this car actually has 14-inch hubcaps because it is the base variant, but you can get a set of 15-inch diamond cut alloy wheels that look rather generic, but they still look pretty nice. The character line continues across the sideline of the body, giving that sporty edge to the side profile of the car as well. And moving to the front, I am a little confused about the front. Yes, you get a clamshell style bonnet that looks attractive, but what I don't really like is the look that you get when you are standing right in front of the car. It just looks like the L-shaped DRLs with the rather large front bumper. It just looks like a young man doing. And once you see it, you just can't unsee it. Can you see it? Do let us know down in the comments down below. But overall, the Swift is a fantastic package. Claiming 25 kilometers to the liter with an AMT gearbox, it is definitely frugal. It is fun, and now it is actually more involving than ever before. And this is definitely something that is going to be a fun little car for you, regardless of how you want to drive it. Yes, 82 horsepower is not an enthusiast dream, but I've said this before and I'll say it again. It's not about how much power you have, it's about how much power you can extract and have fun while doing it. And that's exactly what this car delivers. Do let us know your thoughts on the new Maruti Suzuki Swift. And if you haven't subscribed, what are you doing? Subscribe and never miss out on some of the epic content that we put out on our channel. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.